Hello friends, I am Rashmi. Welcome to SRS Info. Today we will continue with the topic tablet coating and we will discuss about film coating and compression coating today. In the previous class we discussed about sugar coating. So today we will discuss film coating and compression coating. The main steps in the film coating are similar as that of sugar coating. And some steps are skipped in film coating. First, let us understand what are the coating materials which are used in film coating. So the coating materials which are used in film coating are sodium carboxymethyl cellulose, other cellulosic high polymers and polyethylene carbovax 6000. These are the main substances which are used as coating material in film coating, which provides a film coating to the tablets. And these coating materials are dissolved in a volatile solvent, and these volatile solvents are added or sprayed to the tablets which are rotating in the coating pan. This is same as that of the process in sugar coating. Okay, the coating materials are dissolved in a volatile solvent, and this volatile solvent is added or sprayed to the tablets which are rotating in the coating pan. After giving this coating, the tablets are allowed to dry. Okay, and after drying, the next step is coloring. For coloring, the specified or required dyes of the required colors are dissolved in the solvent, and again these are sprayed over the tumbling tablets which are in the coating pan. So the colored or the dyes are dissolved in the solvent and these are sprayed over the tumbling tablets. After this color is completely distributed equally on the tablets, then these tablets are allowed to dry so as to form a permanent film over the tablets. When it gets dried, the color become permanent over the film coated tablets. So this is the process of giving coloring to the film coated tablets. This is the uncoated tablets and this is the traditional coating. And film coating give a complete and permanent color over the tablets. I told you that the process are almost same as that of the process of sugar coating. But there is some advantages of film coating over sugar coating of tablets. Let us understand what are the advantages. And these are very important point on the view of examination. The first thing is the film coating of tablet is more satisfactory method of tablet coating. Why it is more satisfactory? The steps like waterproofing, subcoating and smoothing are not necessary in film coating. These steps can be skipped. Why? Basically, the waterproofing is given for sugar coating tablets. Why? Because the protection of these tablets from the sugar or the water or the solvent of this sugar is very important in the case of waterproofing tablet. But in the case of film coating, the tablet is already protected with the film. So there is no need of waterproofing, so that there is no need of subcoating also. Okay, and in the normal coating or the sugar coating, the smoothing is important. But in the case of film coating, the film coating itself is smooth. By reducing or by skipping these steps, we can reduce the coating time. So this is another advantage. Coating time is reduced to a great extent so that the cost of production is decreased, because these steps are reduced, so that much of technical support and electricity and other materials all can be reduced so that the cost of production can be reduced to a great extent. The next is the tablets of better strength is reduced. In the case of sugar coating, there is a possibility of damage of this tablet due to moisture. But in the case of film coating, it gives a complete and permanent coating of film over the tablet so that it gives the tablet of more strength than that of the tablets of sugar coating. These are the advantages of film coating tablets over sugar coating. The next one is compression coating. Compression coating is also known as press coating or dry coating. The name itself gives an idea that this is dry coating, no use of water. And this is the most important advantage of compression coating of tablet. No water or any solvent is used because there is no need. It is done under pressure, okay, and it is doing under dry conditions. All other steps are same, but still there is some important advantages of compression coating tablet. The most important thing is there is no need of water or any other solvent for this coating. Then dried granules are compressed around the pre-compressed tablet. What happens in this case is, first we have to make a core tablet, then it passes to another die and gives another coating of the next granules, which is given as the granules on the next dry and gives compression, gives the pressure on the die. So first coating is over, then it is passed to the third die, where the third type of granules are supplied to the die and gives a coating. Clear? And this steps like this, it gives a repeated compression and gives repeated coating of incompatible drugs in the form of dry granules. This is the advantage and most important use of this compression coating. The incompatible materials can be incorporated by pressing them in different coatings. And one material can be compressed on the core, which I have already explained to you. One material can be compressed on the core and still another can be compressed on the core and the first coating. First coating, then second coating, third coating. We can increase the layers by giving different type of coating by compression. Repeat action tablets can be prepared. This is next important advantage. That is, repeat action tablets can be prepared by coating the tablets with an appropriate material. By using the appropriate material, we can produce repeat action tablets. And this method is applicable to those drugs which are decomposed in the presence of moisture. There is no question of water, no question of any other solvent. So there is no possibility of damage of tablet due to moisture. In the case of sugar coating and film coating, there is a possibility of the damage of the tablet by the effect of moisture. But in the case of compression coating, the whole process are doing under dry conditions and high pressure is giving to the tablet. So there is no possibility of effect of the moisture on the tablet. The process of compression coating is very simple. See here, core tablet, the first compression, then it goes to the next die, to the next compression with different types of granules. These are explained here. Compressing the granules in the form of a core tablet, the first step. We have to make a core tablet. Then the core so formed is fed to the die of another press. Another press to which the granules of the material to be coated are already supplied. The granules of the next coating are already supplied to the next die, and this coating tablet is passed to the next die, where the compression takes place with the next material, that is the incompatible material, the first coating material. Then this tablet passes to the next die, where the granules are already sent of some other incompatible material, so that it gives a third coating. These steps of repeated compression and repeated coating takes place by the use of different dyes. This is the process of compression coating. See, this is the same is written here. The tablet is then compressed between the punches of the press. Similarly, the second coat can be applied by supplying the coat tablet to the third press and compressed there along with the granules meant for second coating. This is what I have explained in the last slide. Okay, I hope you got it. So we completed sugar coating, film coating and compressed coating. Now the enteric coating and the micro encapsulation. The last two types of coating of tablet we will discuss in the coming classes. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you.